onto Rage.
Ah, nice try on the back one.
Exchange, but Book really coming back on this one.
Fair question is, what is Brian not wearing? Oh, went for the left electric. Oh, getting fancy.
Book is making very, very quick work of Jinpachi at the moment.
How many videos has this guy watched?
Wow, that is a full combo. I think all gym players really need to take some notes.
Book just cruising through that.
Book sensei.
Book sama.
Books are for senseis and for students.
Book senpai.
Book senpai hasn't noticed me yet.
I know. Book senpai, even though he's Kohai.
No.
Maybe we can get Book as an interview.
I don't think he speaks English.
He does.
Oh, does he?
Yeah.
It's up to you.
Let's get Book here.
Huh? Oh, you can ask.
Okay, I'm going to get Book in for a little bit of an interview.
All right.
Okay, guys, we have Book for a quick interview, for about a 1 minute interview about his thoughts on Tekken 7 and also about his match. So, Book, congratulations, first match, you win.
Thank you.
How was it? Do you think it was a hard match for you or easy?
Normal.
Normal?
Yeah.
It's pretty normal. And how long have you been playing Tekken 7 for?
3 days.
Three days?
3 days before tournament began.
you know a lot of combos, actually. How did you figure out all those combos?
I watch on YouTube.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, who do you watch?
Shuri Ni. Shuri from Japan and Ni.
Korea. Oh, okay. Yeah. And who do you think is the better player, gym player?
I think Ni. Ni.
Ni is a better gym player.
Yeah.
Okay. He has maybe better combos and Ni has better combos and better tactics.
Tactics. He very good in tactics.
He has very good tactics. Okay. That's good to hear. And what do you think about Jin in Tekken 7?
I think it's a good, but it's better than Tekken Tag 2.
Okay.
Yeah. He's stronger. And
why do you think so?
Because combo 50%, very high damage.
So yeah. High damage combos.
Yes.
And maybe good Okis as well.
Yeah. Oki, very good.
Okay. All right. Good to hear. So I guess. What do you, Tekken 7, do you think you will continue playing Tekken 7?
Yes, I will do it.
Okay, alright, good to hear. Out of all of the people you versed recently, who is the most best player you versed?
Again.
You've been playing Tekken 7 for 3 days.
Yes.
Who is the best player you have versed so far?
I don't remember him.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So you just a lot of people playing.
Yes.
Okay. All right. And how long are you going to be in Japan for? How long are you going to be in Japan for?
I go back tomorrow.
Two more days?
Two more days, yeah.
Two more days, okay. All right, and you want to play as much Tekken? Okay, good to hear. All right, and finally, I just want to ask one more question. Who do you think will win this Kuro Kuro Cup?
Actually, Ni.
You think Ni?
Yeah.
What about second?
Maybe Nobi.
Nobi,
yeah.
Okay. And third, maybe you? third place book, right?
I'm not sure.
Okay. What place do you want to have? Maybe third, fourth?
Anything.
Anything, yes. Okay. But hopefully you get out of the good luck with pool four. So you are pool four, right?
Yes.
So good luck with pool four, and hopefully we see more matches.
Okay, thank you.
All right, thank you. KO. Round two. Okay, guys, that was Book. So, so sorry I took a break from actually commentating on the stream, but just got Book's sort of opinions on the game, and it was pretty good. I really think that Book's being really, really modest. I think he has a really good chance of getting like maybe third place or fourth place. Maybe not first. I think that's gonna go with Ni or Nobi, but he's very, very good at it. All right, I don't even know who's playing anymore.
Ah, shit.
Nikyu Sensei.
Oh, yeah, Sensei.
Yep.
So we have Sensei and Hiro.
Hiro Genesis.
Hiro to Genesis and Sensei. Is this game one or two?
I think. I don't know.
Like, is the game going to be on long enough to matter?
Okay, so we have Hiroto Genesis and Nikyu Sensei.
That wasn't me doing the interview. That was actually Lychee. I was interviewing the other Thai guy. Alright, Book is on the Nico Nico stream, taking house again.
Thanks, guys. We'll probably have another interview. Actually, I'll get JT to interview the next person. Probably Ni. So we'll probably bring in Ni to do it like maybe a 1 minute interview when he comes along. What? Yeah, sure, you're fine.
You like seven? You're like interviewing a fob. Or like my students in Shugakko. Do you like seven?
Yes, I love seven.
Oh, wait, sorry. So, Hyung, seven, do you like seven?
I like seven. Very much.
Right, game two. Oh, new one. Oh, it's Kanchanch. All right, we're on. New game. It's Nikyu Sensei versus Kanchan. Kanchan, she said hi earlier. Kurokuro's girlfriend. Get ready for the next battle. Looks like she got demoted this week. She was one rank higher earlier. No, it's still him. Yeah, still him.
Okay, we have Kurokuro's girlfriend versus Nikyu Sensei. Actually, I think Kanchan's gone has improved quite significantly from Tekken Tag 2 to now.
You know, she's been putting in a lot of hours in Tekken 7. I've seen her here a lot.
And she has obviously a very good teacher.
Yes, exactly. She has
a very good one-on-one teacher.
Exactly.
Private teacher.
Private lessons, very good.
You know what I mean? Bonchico wow wow. Okay. All right. Let's go. We got Nikyu Sensei versus Kancha. Nikyu.
Oh,
having
my God.
One.
Throwing her everywhere. Calm the fuck. Why isn't she teching?
Okay.
All right. Kanchan doing Kanchan.
Oh, Kanchan not getting any of the punishers in.
Oh, I think she's nervous.
Oh,
she's not
Nikyu, Nikyu getting the first round.
Letters.
Perfect. Kanchan, I think she needs to sort of calm down a little bit, be able to get space. Oh, she should have punished that one. Oh, doesn't get the.
No, you don't understand. Kanchan's so confident, she don't need guarantee. Guarantee's for noobs. That's what she thinks, see?
Oh, Nikyu Sensei doesn't get the punish there. Kanchan breaks that throw.
Throw break on accident. Oh, I got hype. Look, she's like, nah, that you suck too bad. I'm not going to punish that.
Yeah, Kanchan from Taiwan.
Correct.
Right here. King.
Look at that. Oh!
Oh, Kanchan coming in.
Look at that.
Oh, coming in for the Mumbo. Oh. Yo, 1-1, Kanchan to Nikyu, 1.
I just took a note right there. I'm ripping that.
All right, plus frames here.
All right, they
Kanchan trying to slide through here.
Trying to go for the big launcher.
Kanchan trying to come in, trying to close in on this.
Oh, she got it, 4-4-4. Oh, if you don't know, 4-4-4 safe now. Cheap.
Oh yeah, Kanchan really trying to bring this back in.
What's he trying to do?
What's he trying to do?
Sensei
coming
dude,
in,
Sensei
Kanchan. Base. Oh, coming in for
the
unblockable. Coming in for
face.
It.
Going another, for the second one.
Let's go for another one.
No,
oh,
going for the
comes in.
Going for the
overhead kick.
Knucklehead. Knuckle punch.
Yeah, Kanchan bringing it back.
Yeah, she
with some of those
overhead.
She's flying everywhere.
She likes emphasizing the robot more than the girl. Look at that.
That's very Kanchan-like.
Very Kanchan-like. She's girly enough. Don't need any more of that.
Needs a robot part of her. Embracing the robot side of her.
Do you think maybe she wishes she was Elisa?
I'm pretty sure she does.
Okay.
I wish I was a robot.
You can stop now.
I could take off my head.
Please stop. Oh, good. She actually punished.
Yes.
She's like, okay, I'm done fucking with you. I'm actually going to punish now.
All right. That's one to Kanchan.
And it looks like Book won his match against Gafarino. Sending him to losers. Kanchan won. She gonna take it? She may look like she's doing nothing, but she's clearly doing something to be holding that rank. I did not promise dad jokes. They come when the opportunity arises.
Okay, fine. Kanchan completes me.
Kanchan conned him out. Out of that one. That's not a dad joke. That's a 15-year-old joke.
Yeah. Well,
in bed.
Okay. Well, Kanchan coming in for the second win here.
Dad jokes are generally really bad, obvious puns. But they're so bad you laugh anyway. Oh, she tried going for the buffer. Oh.
Oh, punishes it.
Oh, she's sick of this already. She's like, fuck it. And we're going to start punching.
Oh, boom. Kick. Wake up.
Okay, okay, Zeme.
No, and wasn't on the wall enough.
Oh. Damn, abusing that down three. Down three, hands down, the best move in Elise's arsenal now. Minus 15, don't care. Best move in her arsenal, by a lot.
Wow, Nikkyu Sensei trying to bring it back
trying
with the combos.
Teach her something.
And Kanchan's all like...
Nah, teacher... Kanchan's like, I got it. No! No, why are you trying to be fancy? She's trying to get the wall hit. Oh! Screw it! Hop kick! The zero F hop kick! Like... And none it. There you go, clarification, Taiwan. Oh, what she gonna do? Oh, she's going for the chainsaw mix up. Good fly? Nope. Nope, she blew and died.
Kanchan about to close this match off. Nikkyu Sensei trying to bring it back with some of those throws, but isn't coming back. Oh!
Trading!
Trading with an unblockable. Oh, is Nikkyu Sensei, is he going to be stupid enough to be hit by that again? Oh!
Look at that.
Nikkyu Sensei comes back.
With a micro sidestep. Just enough to make her miss.
Oh, Nikkyu Sensei first blood for this one.
Again, no punish.
Oh, not much black dashing in this game.
Oh no!
They really is trying to get as much damage as possible.
No ducking. Dick jab. Didn't break the two. She's probably a one match.
Boom. Okay, life lead for Nikkyu Sensei.
Come on, rocket punch! Rocket punch!
Just I think running away because he's got that life lead, just wants to keep it at the moment and wait for Kanchan to whip. And I think he's actually figured out. Whoa! Boom, guaranteed.
Sensei giving her a lesson. In turtling.
I think if Nikkyu Sensei keeps turtling and really waits for Kanchan to make those mistakes, I think he could really take this round.
She ducked it!
Boom!
That was legit! She should have done flying too, but whatever. That should save.
That was large punishable.
Didn't look like it, but not.
Oh, bang! Too much on the wall. Can't get this.
Up kick! Down back four!
Needs
down
to go.
Four.
Oh.
No, he dead! You
boom!
Dead. Kanchan takes it.
Kanchan takes this match.
Had no life to be trying to rage art there.
Have no business doing that shit.
All right, that's another girl always. What? Wait, did Yamato get eliminated?
I don't know. Is Yamato still in the game? We need girls in this. So Kanchan makes it out of the first loser's bracket. So I'm going to refresh the page just to see where we are at. Okay, so... wow, Raven Boy.
Oh, wow. Yo, Kanchan! Yo, Kanchan! Yo, 7-ban!
Raven Boy from Australia, again through his first two games. Fighting Book right now to get into the winner's final.
Nyo versus Kanchan. So Kanchan is still in this game.
Hey, really quick, take a picture of me.
Are you standing on one side?
My friend's trying to make me jealous. Thank you.
Hendrix!
So just give you an update, actually Raven Boy versing Book right now. One and two. I'm just gonna have a peek and see what Book and Raven Boy are up to right now. Raven Boy down 1-0 at the moment. This could be anybody's game, but Raven Boy doing a very, very good job keeping his own. Book, but still keeping the lead. Rage R from Raven Boy, but whiffs and gets and Book gets the lead again. 2-0 to Book, Raven Boy 0. Raven Boy came plus frames was the Crash Dash 2. Raven Boy desperately trying to get some more damage in, but Book really seems to be getting the best of Raven Boy at the moment. Really, really just calmly chipping away the damage. It's not looking good for Raven Boy at all. Not at all. Raven Boy, Book wins the second one. So Book gets, Raven Boy is knocked out. And Book goes on to the finals for the pool four.
All right, who is it?
Gafferino versus.
Oh, what happened?
Okay, back to our matches. Gafferino from Saudi Arabia versus Poifro.
Yes, I know the name's really long, but his name, Saudi Arabia's not a short name. Okay, so Oscar versus Claudio. Gafferino for the throw. What's he gonna do? Keeping his spacing. Really respecting Claudio. Down for 4-2. Uses candy, didn't work.
Gafferino trying to close this out before he uses a rage art. Oh!
2-3!
Nice! Gafferino waited for that. Fading out that whiff, making sure that he gets that.
Oh! Going for that bull. Oh, got the counter hit.
Poiful.
Oh, just can't.
Oh, really not on top of his game at the moment. Gafferino.
Right now. Deer in the headlights.
Gafferino really trying to get this. Trying to get those frame traps, so Gafferino's having none of this.
4-1-1-3.
Gets him into the wall.
Oh, Gafferino on a rampage.
Oh, doesn't get that combo. But oh, nice. Oh, let's
converted.
See. Oh, nice. Gets it. Gets a very janky combo there, but really gets it in. Okay, so Gafferino gets the first round. 11-0.
All right, second game. Gafferino gonna shut him out, or what's gonna happen? Really just trying to bring it in there, huh?
Yeah.
Let's see if Gafferino can just seal the deal right away, or if it's
Arabian Nights! Arabian Nights!
I regret asking you to do this with me.
Arabian Nuska. So it's interesting how Poifuru is
apparently from Osaka.
No, he's a Nidaime Jackler.
but he's not using Jack.
Yeah, that's quite interesting. Actually, I saw Jackler yesterday.
He's coming today.
I saw him yesterday.
Oh, and on here?
No, in Shibuya.
What was he doing there?
He was playing. He was playing Law, actually. So he's kind of taking a sabbatical from Jack.
Wait, Law?
Yeah.
Well, I think after Jack got nerfed out of S tier and back into C tier, yeah.
Yeah, so Jackler playing, not playing Jack anymore and playing Law, so I guess taking a book from there, this Knee Diamond Jackler, Jackler the second.
Yeah, that's what it means, second generation Jack.
But I mean, did he get permission from Jack, or is he just like...
idolizing. You know, I noticed in Tekken 7 there's a lot of Knee Diamonds.
Yeah, maybe that should be Knee Diamond or something.
Knee Diamond Mamba.
Diamond what?
Mamba.
Mamba.
Or Knee Diamond Tare, I guess. No, but he's a Shaoyu player.
I know.
If anything, I'm Knee Diamond Tare.
Alright,
no, back. I'm Knee Diamond Yoshiden. And I'm Knee Diamond Yoshiden. Alright! Gavarino just commanding this match. 7 golden letters. One more.
Gavarino.
Does that... Wait, Knee Diamond MSR is from Osaka, isn't he?
Yep.
Yeah, Knee Diamond MSR is from Osaka, so he's not here today. Granted, this... granted, Poifert is also from Osaka, so not sure what he's doing up here.
So, Poifert trying to bring this back with a life lead at the moment.
Got a really good life lead there, but he can't block it! Didn't block the sweep, taking a combo.
That's the biggest thing about this. If you have a gimmick that not many players use, you could really win this match.
Well, he just uses candy on him. That's a gimmick.
That's a gimmick right there. So I think maybe for this match, we need Poifert to use a little bit more gimmicks in this and stop being a little bit basic. Okay, Poifert, stop being
basic.
Yeah, Poifert, stop being a basic bitch.
Hella basic.
I'm calling you out.
Yeah, MSR Junior still plays. MSR Senior, not really. But you know, I haven't really seen Junior at any tournaments, huh?
He plays Blaze Blue.
Oh, God. All right.
Boom!
No point again!
No!
And no punish! And the Power Crush. Screw it, Power Crush. You know, I think running 2 should be considered Power Crush.
It probably is.
I know. But it's not even Power Crush, it's just full-on avoid. As built-in parry.
Well, one thing I learned quite recently is that running 2 with Claudio actually high crushes.
Yep.
Oh!
At point-blank range.
At point-blank range.
It beats out 10-frame jab.
Oh. Okay, Gavarino in trouble now.
Don't know.
He's not very good with pressure at the moment. Really mixing
good,
it up.
Good call.
Nice.
He's in the lead.
He's trying to be the defensive game, okay. Trying to bait him out.
Still up on life.
Making sure that you know, he makes a mistake somewhere so he can tax end on it.
Poifert
didn't get that.
Those hop kicks. Down back 3.
Oh, nice. Gavarino.
Called it.
Closes out this match.
Took it. Good job. Good play. Good gameplay by Gavarino. All right, we got another girl up. I've never heard of her before. Do I? Is that...
Okay, Ku-chan, also known as the Tekken Idol.
Hi.
Yeah. So we have Ku-chan, who is the Tekken Idol. She's on a lot of the photo shoots and the female Tekken players. She's one of the...
Was she the Chloe cosplayer in December?
Maybe.
Oh. So here's the thing about Namco. They actually, in Japan, hire girls to be in the Tekken community. Like, during Tekken Tag 2, you had Hinopi.
Yep.
I don't know where she is now. And now we have
I think Kuchan is one of those players. She really likes the game. You know, she's a Tekken player by heart. You know, I've seen her like take down notes. She has a notebook and she takes down notes. She's a very, very kind of studious and very, very hardworking in regards to learning about Asuka. It's very hard to not like her, actually. Both with looks and the just the fact that she really likes this game.
Who is she learning? Who's she learning from?
She learns by herself.
Really?
But I think a lot of the good Tekken players, they really like her.
They like any cute girl.
Well, she's cute and she's very nice. She really listens
round one.
And she really wants to get good at this game.
So it's like really earnest.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, chicken!
Gafferino, chicken!
He went for the fuck you! Like, I ain't basic.
Asuka versus Asuka.
Well, I mean, for all of Tekken Tag 2, Nobi was paid to be a Tekken teacher as well.
True. Okay, tries to get that throw in.
Oh, good break,
Kuchan,
though.
I'm breaking that throw.
Even during the hold.
Okay, right. So... Switching sides in the moment. Kuchan trying to break it through. Both are rage. We don't know what's going to happen here. They both have the space open.
They're about the same life.
Kuchan trying to bait him out.
Oh, good. Can-can.
Can-can kicks here.
Oh,
Kuchan, what's going to happen here? Kuchan takes on second round. That's what I'm talking about. We're hype here in Akihabara Legend Land.
Oh, nice combo. You see that? She did it.
Wow. So Kuchan.
Kuchan's notes are legit. Look.
Boom. Look at this. Oh, my God. Well, I can hear all the Asuka screaming at the moment. They're loving Kuchan.
Oh, my God.
Like, they already loved her, but yeah. They're just loving her even more.
You didn't know she was a girl, and now you have it. She's actually a real player.
Exactly. Well, you know, she plays Asuka.
Oh, she ate the counter hit, but it didn't just convert.
It doesn't matter because Kuchan won 3-0. It don't matter if you get hit by the stupidest thing as long as you win.
It kind of matters.
Or, you know, she could be like, I don't care. At least I'm not ugly.
Why does every girl sound like a Valley girl to you?
Oh my God, like, so basic.
That's not me. I'm not doing that. Ebok, that's not me.
Oh my God, you have such a basic Asuka.
I'm gonna take a break, guys. I can't hang out with this guy anymore.
All right, we're back with Asuka versus Asuka. Kuchan versus Gafferino. Kuchan, the girliest girl in this house, and Gafferino, probably the manliest man in this house.
He's pretty damn manly. Wait, is that Gafferino's outfit? Oh no, okay, yeah, he got the tan and the... He's got the bikini going, pretty damn manly. Her, all pink in a schoolgirl outfit with the bunny ears, pretty damn girly. Oh, down back 4-3 hits anyway.
Gafferino coming in.
He's got the lead. Can he seal it? Can he keep the lead? No. I don't know who. Todd Kuchan.
Oh,
but they did a great job.
Oh, Kuchan knows this game.
She knows her character.
She knows her character very, very well. Gafferino is in trouble.
What's he gonna do?
Doesn't know what to do here.
Okay, and that didn't
You can already hurt, almost hear Kuchan going, wow, you really don't know this character as much as I do.
Well, you know. I mean, to be fair, Gafferino has a great time outside of Tekken.
Exactly.
You seen his post? Damn. He's like hanging out at Mount Fuji and crap.
Well, has a life.
Yeah, I know. It has a social life. I never see him. I only see him for majors. I'd take the trade.
Oh, Gafarino coming back with Oki.
All right, good one. What's he going to do? 4-4-3, run up. Oh, no, he's going.
Oh, unblockable.
Why do they never convert to a combo?
Oh, got the wall combo. Yep. Kuchan trying to bring it back. Had to throw. Gafarino doesn't break this. What's going to happen here? Kuchan goes for another throw. Boom. Oki time.
What?
Bang.
No cares.
YOLO. No care right here. We got this. Kuchan 2, Gafarino 1. Saudi Arabia, represent Kuchan, representing the ladies in this house.
Yeah,
who run
girls.
This world? Ladies. Who run this world? Kuchan.
Well, maybe not, but I mean, I wouldn't mind a world run by Kuchan, actually. It might be really pink.
I think it'll be very, very pink, very, very effeminate.
Okay,
I think it's the kind of world that JT can live in.
I wear purple, not pink.
Nice comeback by Kuchan.
Well, Kuchan takes it. Gafarino out. Is he out?
That makes Kuchan go on to the next round.
Why am I not playing League?
Okay, so in 7, we have Kanchan versus Kuchan, so it's going to be
a cat fight. Oh my god, we got a cat fight on 7-8.
Oh.
Oh my god, they look like they don't even want to fight anymore. We're like, please!
There was a little bit of lesbian action going on there.
Oh my god.
I was a little turned on.
Oh my god. The Thai guy taking video now.
Kuchan versus Kanchan.
Book's photographer is taking video of this fight.
So Kuchan versus Kanchan, probably the sexiest fight of the day.
Oh, Yu's girlfriend is Mogutan. I haven't seen her in a while.
Yeah, I haven't either. Actually, no, she plays Claudio.
Yeah, I know. Well, she plays Claudio. She's pretty decent, but I haven't seen her in a minute.
Exactly.
Like, even when I come here, this is where she plays.
Yeah. I'm just going to watch this match.
I know. I don't care what's on our stream.
Yeah, it's okay. So Kuchan versus Kanchan.
Elisa versus Asuka.
Cat fight, let's go.
Cat fight. How sexy is it?
Let's be in cat fight, let's go.
Sorry,
that's my fantasy.
We got the princess in pink, which, by the way, this is on Shooty stream.
So princess in pink and princess in pink, okay.
Princess in pink, robot in purple.
Oriental Princess and Pig versus Oriental Princess. Okay, I get it. This is like an exhibition match, really.
Kinda. I mean, these two actually are probably gonna be in the qualifiers for Worlds.
Probably. Okay, Kuchan tries to get a reversal in. Kanchan reads it, puts in a low.
Oh.
Kuchan going in for an overhead.
Elisa 1+2 to the face.
Bang.
Oh
puts Kuchan into rage.
Oh, right over her. What?
Kuchan in trouble right now.
1+2.
Boom. Oh.
Kuchan ran right in there.
Damn. Kuchan takes on the first round.
That was Kanchan's.
Level boy six.
Kanchan. Bringing in the power moves into the game.
Kanchan in the lead.
Running mix-ups for the win.
What's gonna happen?
Yeah, Kanchan is not happy. She's bringing in the claws in this game.
Oh! Kanchan takes second round.
Very
convincingly.
1-1.
Oh, opening moves out for 1+2. Don't know why.
Both have their paws out at the moment.
Oh, man.
Really going in for this cat fight.
Chain paws. She had her chain paws out. Oh, 1+2 hits again. Kanchan taking a grip. Looks like a little over 30%. We still got nothing on our stream.
All right. 1-1. Boom.
8 p.m. PM wa ato. He doesn't care. Yeah, Kurokuro is saying time backwards, but he's like, nope. I'm in Japan. Time is backwards. Anyways, back to it. Oh, Kanchan took third round. PM 8 wa...
Wakannai. 8 to PM.
PM to AM wa ato. Okay. All right, tied up. 2-2. first hit goes to
2-2 for this exhibition cat fight.
She didn't BDC 8-2.
Oh, Destroy Amoy for Kanchan. She has the chainsaws out. Going in for some chainsaw action.
Still 1+2, 8
chainsaws, yeah.
Chain paws.
Oh my god! Oh,
boom! Kanchan game one with fucking Destroy Mode.
Destroyer Mode Kanchan. She is definitely in Destroyer Mode today.
Oh man, she got destroyed.
Destroyed. Kanchan.
Right out the gate, she's like Destroyer. Robot mode. She's like, nope, no more cutesy crap. Russian robot Lego.
Well. Kanchan, I think she's got the lead now, so she's gonna be very, very cocky in this next match. Kuchan, what she really needs to do in this match is to make sure that she doesn't get hit by a lot of those gimmicks that Kanchan has.
Wait, is Kuchan opening her notebook?
I think maybe she is.
That notebook? I see a notebook. She's reading during the load screen. I think she has at least a counter reference.
All right, Kuchan, I think she needs to sort of backdash, step away for a second.
I think she needs to not get hit by random 1+2s.
Right, that too, but...
Because I think she's caught at the down back of the BDC.
Right.
On hit.
So, Kuchan still could win this
from
one.
Australia, it was not America, homie.
It was a very, very close match between Kuchan and Kuchan last time with 2-2. So two out of three, but this time it could go around. Kuchan could very, very well win this one. I don't know who to root for here. Basically, they're both very, very, very.
I'm gonna go with my
good
man,
players.
I'm gonna go with my instinct, my manly instinct, and go for Kuchan.
Okay, why is that?
My manly instinct.
Your manly.
If you follow me.
What's left of your manly instincts?
I'm not wearing pink yet.
Okay. Just wearing purple.
Light purple with silver dress pants.
Right. Very manly.
Hey, it's very Charlotte. It's very old Charlotte. Okay, Kanchan with a lead. Round two to Kanchan. We're up 1-1. And
1-1
again, no. Kuchan ain't having it.
Oh, Kuchan goes for the launch.
4-2 hits. Combo.
Anything could happen right now.
Side down back three, down to half life. Kanchan half life, gets countered, down to a quarter life. Oh, 20 down.
Boom, gets half life right there.
Oh. Kanchan takes her down to half with a running two.
Oh, tries to get that.
Try getting the combo.
Okay.
Oh no. Kanchan. She's running out alive. Oh, Kuchan takes it.
Kuchan takes this lead.
Oh, Kanchan in the lead right now. Oh, what's going to happen? Okay. Try getting the down forward 1-4.
Oh,
got
Kuchan gets that combo.
Did not tech. Don't know what they're doing there.
Kuchan gets a throw.
Life's all tied up. Oh no! 4-3-2! Boom!
Kanchan, 2-0.
2-2. 2-up.
2-2. Oh wow, 2-2 again.
Booster kick! Down 3? 3! Oh, 1, whatever, works. Okay. Nice. Try going for a counter, didn't get it. Got punished.
Kuchan's in trouble.
Kuchan down to 20%. Oh, nice sidewalk!
Boom! Brings it back with a sidestep.
Good sidewalk. Hop kick, got nothing.
Kuchan has Kanchan on the wall.
I think that's it? Is that it? No.
Is that it? This is it. Let's go.
Kuchan takes
Kuchan
it.
Kuchan takes it. 1-1. This is so hype. This is the hypest game.
Yeah. Fuck book matches. This is where it's at.
Cat fights. That's where we have
cat fights.
I don't like Oscar, period. I watched the Chinese 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 Chin
But you have to admit, she's pretty good.
Yeah.
I thought that, like, even against Conchon, I'm like, wait, what?
Yeah. She's good.
Dude, nobody here cares about the rest of this tournament anymore. This is the highlight. Knee can go home now. We're done. This is it.
All right, it looks like we have technical problems on the infamous cat fight.
We have a technical Kuchon's, difficulty on Kuchon's machine.
Kuchon's machine has a button that's faulty at the moment.
She won anyway, though.
She won anyway, but her 3 button isn't working at all.
Really?
Yep.
Really? Okay.
So Kurokuro's come in for repairs.
No, give it to Kurokuro, the jack of all trades here. The Leo of all trades here. I'm going to stop now.
Exactly. Oh, on the other machine, we have Raven Boy on losers.
Raven Boy. Who is he fighting? Book played that guy too. We got 2 people that Book beat duking it out.
Beating it out.
It's, what is it? The first guy.
Raven Boy.
Oh, Chinpachi.
Raven Boy versus Chinpachi.
Okay. Chinpachi in the lead. All right, Chinpachi took round 2. Unfortunately, Kurokuro is not even in his seat. He's fixing the machine. Kurokuro, every tournament here, every major tournament here is named after a player. That player is the head of that tournament. So if, like, you go to Nobi Cup, don't expect Nobi to look at the stream. You go to Kurokuro Cup, don't expect Kurokuro to look at the stream. They're running the tournaments. Would you want a tournament named after yourself? It's a lot of responsibility.
I don't know. It's a lot of responsibility, which I really can't be bothered.
Yeah.
What about yours?
Me?
JT Chinoya.
No, it'd be the Cha-Cha Cup.
Cha-Cha High?
The Cha-Cha High. Sounds like a drink. It's a cup of Cha-Cha.
Cha-Cha High.
Cha-Cha High.
We should make a Cha-Cha High.
I'm down.
We'll be like 5 people.
And they're all in our, just our friends.
Yeah, exactly.
And Tekken Tag 2 tournament. At my place.
Exactly.
Oil. Haita. Haita. Nan put not nandai. Fiber. Okay guys, next pool you guys are gonna have another treat. We have one of the best Shaoyus in Japan. He's the best at playing just like Sodam. One of Sodam's former teammates lives here in Japan, and they fight online a lot, and he thought for like a month it was actually Sodam. That's how much they play alike. So you got what's effectively Nidai Sodam in pool 5. It's going to be fun. I really hope he's on pool on our station.
All right, Kurokuro is still trying to fix the machines, but it looks like Kanchan and Kuchan have switched machines for the time being, so they can look to move on with the match. Just to remind you guys, Kuchan and Kanchan at the moment are 1-1. They are evenly matched. Each match has gone for 2 rounds to 2. And come down to a final match. So they're both very, very evenly matched at this stage. And this is the final round. This is the final match to try and find who will win. All right, Kanchan takes the first match. First round. Oh, Kuchan trying to get that counter, get a reversal in, and then a low, but doesn't get it through. Kuchan pushing it back, trying to get that wall splat, but no, Kanchan's reading that very, very well. Oh, Kanchan's in trouble. 2-0 to Kanchan. Okay, one more match and until Kuchan is out of this. Kanchan trying to win this. Oh! Kanchan, oh, almost wins, but Kuchan gets, oh, Kuchan's still in the game. Oh, tries to get that Rage Art in, blocked and launched. Okay, so Kanchan wins the girl fight.
Damn it, I lost.
And so Kanchan is into the next man. Bad luck.
Did you just say the next man?
Match. Match.
お願いします。
Okay. Okay. Okay, guys. We're wrapping up the fourth pool, and we're going to start the fifth pool in about 10 minutes. So hang tight. One of the last matches right now is Kanchan versus Chinpachi. Chinpachi's up one. Not PM 3:15.
そう。 All right, guys, we got Amigo and Kagemaru on our stream. We got a treat here today.
Okay, guys, so Kanchan's being a douchebag right now and took my seat, so I have to commentate from the side of the table. Inoka. Omokunai. Karui ka? Jaiyo. Kagemaru? Are you serious? Oh, wow, we got a match for you guys. We got Amigo versus Kagemaru. Amigo's also a top-level Jin player. We got Kagemaru. Kagemaru is someone you don't want to fight. What was his rank? Kagemaru is like a Raijin, right?
All right, so we got Kagemaru versus Amigo in this stream.
Katta! She didn't appreciate me sitting in her lap.
Okay.
That's right.
Okay, so Amigo versus Kagemaru. Okay, so who do you think is gonna win this one?
Oh. I haven't even seen these ranks in person yet.
Okay, so who do you think is gonna win?
Wait.
Predictions. Let's go. Go, 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 go. I think
I'm gonna put it on Amigo, honestly. I fought him a bunch of times. It wasn't a match.
they were just abuses. Animal abuse.
Did that tell you enough?
I think Kagemaru still has enough. He's very much a tournament player. And I think Kagemaru has a very good chance of winning this one as well. So it's going to be a very interesting match between Kagemaru and Amigo. And obviously, Kagemaru has that sort of charisma about him and a brand that he's one of the best players in Japan.
I'll give you he has the brand, but now we're talking the skill. We're talking this
let's
guy.
Let's go, Kagemaru. Let's go, Amigo. Let's go. Well, we'll see in a
this
second.
This guy is tied with me for ranks.
Well, let's look and see which one's going to take this one. Boom!
Good
gets
call.
That damage.
Good call.
Kagemaru getting that lead in. Boom! Gets that screw. Well, maybe you have to take the thoughts about who's gonna win this one.
Oh. No.
Boom, Amigo coming in for the.
No, I don't
boom.
Take it back. I don't take it back.
Okay, Amigo gets that.
That ain't no S tier no more.
Okay, let's have a look. Oh, Amigo comes in with a good read, launches Kagemaru onto the wall. A wall damage coming in. Oh, Amigo coming in, advancing on like there's no tomorrow.
Okay, you know, you
gets him on the wall.
You wanna know what I think Amigo's main advantage is? Movement. His movement's a lot higher than Kagemaru's.
Kagemaru.
And he's dead. Again.
Okay. So, Kagemaru is dead again, but...
Wonky, where still, you been all day, son?
Still 2-0.
Okay, got down back two. Back two,
back
nothing.
Two.
Nothing, see, you can't do anything big on Amigo. You can't debug him.
Oh, boom. Half-life already. Oh, Kagemaru's getting...
Dead.
Oh, nice punish there. Boom!
Okay.
Here we go. Let's see if he can bring this one out.
Pity round.
Boom. All right, Kagemaru, 2-1. Let's go.
Oh, no. Whoa! Okay.
Boom. Okay. Screw there. And can it take him to the wall. Go for the wall combo. Boom!
Saturday.
Half-life.
Saturday means you're not busy, Wonk.
All right, let's go.
Oh,
boom,
shoot.
Counter hit, gets Amigo onto Rage. What's gonna happen here?
He's gonna
that
die.
That could be anybody's match here. Boom, Amigo.
I didn't say who would die.
Kagemaru takes on 2-2. This is a very, very close match. We're very, very strong players here. Amigo gets in for a
up
for neutral 4 combo.
Oh.
Boom, onto the wall.
Half
life.
Where your life
this
at?
Is where it's coming from.
Oh, there it is.
Nice
okay.
Punish.
I'm sorry.
Amigo coming
sorry.
In with a power driver. Boom!
Oh,
reading this match. Screw taking it out.
I don't
Kagemaru.
Take it back. I don't take it back. I will stand by Amigo.
Kagemaru.
You know why? He's my fucking Amigo. Oh.
Kagemaru takes on the second round. First round. First round goes to Kagemaru.
First round, Kagemaru. He made some really good adjustments there. Very good adjustments. but I'm still standing by Amiga. I don't give a fuck.
So Jack's gone through a lot of Nurse recently. And
that thing was like 20 lines long. Was it useful? Make it worse. Yes. That is what that list said.
Yep. Yeah. Jack's really gone through a lot of nerfs within the Tekken 7 arena, but Kagemaru is taken very, very loyal. He sticks to his character, and he really wants to play him out to the fullest.
Well, to be fair, Josie became a girl, so that might disqualify her. Or Bruce became a girl.
I think props to Kagemaru for sticking with his character.
No, you know, I give him props for that. I just think Amigo's really fucking good.
Yep, I think so too, but Kagemaru is very much a tournament player. He can read the opponent, download them as quickly as possible, and win the match.
Okay, well, we'll see how it goes. Game two.
Boom! Again! Zero Amigo alone. Goes for that outboard four combo. Maximum damage.
Oh, and?
Gets him downstairs.
Down
gets
that 2-2.
Oh, goes in for a half-life damage.
Oh!
Boom!
60%!
Where did his damage, where did his life go?
I don't know, 40. I don't care.
Where did his life go? Boom.
I don't know.
Kagemaru doesn't
Everyone's
give a shit.
Life's missing. About even.
Wow.
About
in,
even.
In two.
Oh!
Boom.
Next.
That's how you win a match.
Damn. Dude, that forward four needs to be toned down. That thing is ridiculous.
But both Amigo and Kagemaru. I remember one time, Nobi was asked who would be the best, one of the best tournament players, and he was lucky Kagemaru, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
You know, I didn't really even, I'll be honest, I didn't even know who Amigo was until 7.
Right. But he's always been a very good player. But Kagemaru coming in for the wall, this is the most...
Didn't get the punish.
To be quite honest, Jack is the most scariest on the wall. So that was a very, very good advantage for Kagemaru.
All right.
I think we need...
Oh, nice. Good duck.
Kagemaru
good
needs to take Amigo to the wall more often. The more he gets him onto the wall, the more chances he has. Debugger!
It's begun!
Debugger! That's how you got to do it.
No, you don't.
Boom! Down 4-2 out of nowhere. Gets him for a second round.
Kagemaru,
2-1.
Ain't taking it back.
Amigo in trouble right here. Hasta la, amigo. Hasta la vista, baby.
Oh, it wasn't electric, so don't count.
Boom.
No.
All right, tries to go for the Oki.
Okay.
Picks him up. An interesting juggle there by Kagemaru.
I think he's just trying to get any hit he could in. Oh!
Boom!
Oh, the hop kick again! You got down 4-2, we got hop kick.
Oh, equals it up with 2-2. Still anybody's game, but Kagemaru has one match ahead of Amigo, and Amigo really needs to take this one home so it can make the match interesting.
Fair enough.
Right. So, Kagemaru gets him into the wall.
It
half life.
No, big boot. Oh, missed. No punish.
Tries to get that low, but didn't get it quite. Oh.
Dropped it.
Didn't get it.
Uh-oh. It's over. It's
chipping
over.
Chipping the damage. Amigo still on rage. It could be his game. This could be it. This could be it, but we don't know.
Don't give
up. It's intense. Oh my god.
It's a rage moment. Hard
Debugger.
Nah, man. You gotta do it like America. Debugger.
Kagemaru takes on the first round. Knocks out Amigo onto losers.
I still stand by Amigo. I will not take back my claim. I think Amigo is a really good player.
I'm not saying who's the better player. I just think that Kagemaru has a better chance at these tournaments.
Well, we'll see how it goes.
He has the brand, and he has the calm, he has the wits, and he has the experience.
How long has he been playing?
Kagemaru has been playing since Tekken 4.
Okay.
Definitely has the experience.
Got some seniority on me there.
All right, that was a hype match there.
Refresh. Where? Oh, no. We're probably... Omar? Omar Nuri, y'all.
サッカーはいる。サッカー。サッカーは来てる。サッカーパン。サッカーはいる。サッカー。サッカーは。サッカーこれでしょ。オーバーマンですね。サッカー。はい。じゃあ。
Okay, still figuring out the next matches.
Sorry.
Stay tuned.
Sorry, guys. Nidaime Sodam's going over to Shooty's stream. So if you want to see some top tier Shaoyu, go to stream 2. We're still waiting to get our assignment. We got another lane, guys! Rafume is actually probably top three lings in Japan. I think I'm number 3. Well, it's A-R-A-F-U-M-E. Look at that, Seiryu. This is currently the highest ranked Ling in Japan. So,
okay, I'm just going to leave this commentary up to JT. Okay. I'm just going to be in the support lead.
I'm going to start talking. You just sit. Get over it.
Okay, so what do you think about Rafune?
Rafune, very solid player. He focuses on speed, it's solid. It's like me if I was twice as fast.
Okay, but I'm not sure if they understand what the extent of this is.
Okay, you can see right now, very fast, very sharp on the punishment. He doesn't really slow down. He actually likes staying on the offensive.
What do you think the chances of him for this match is?
Like, against the green rank, like 99?
99%.
I'll give you a 99-1 odd.
Okay. Well, if he was to lose, why would you think he's going to be losing?
Because of his high offensive, how much he likes to attack, as you can see, he'll run into things.
Okay. So what kind of advice do you have for fighter?
Fighter? I mean, you know, play like normal king. See it like that? It's like, you know, the backup to half screen crouch and wait to throw in the wall staying down for it too.
Right. Okay. Really so solid. A lot of waiting.
See, that's what happens if you don't wait. You get launched by Ling spam. That was spam. That wasn't even him reacting. That was pure spam. I mean, this guy, see, if he was reacting, he wouldn't be canceling.
All right, so he needs to kind of step back for a second and wait for him to get him.
Wow. See, Rafume, very good on the count, on the turnarounds.
Turns him around with 1-1.
Yeah.
Interesting that fighter was able to take it in the second round. So still get some damage in.
Getting some damage in with the 4-4-1s. He's trying to get the guarantee. I don't know why he's not doing down 4-2-1 after scissor kick. That's actually the best thing. He doesn't do it. He tried going for the mid. Oh, wow. He committed to the duck. Okay. Going in. Didn't break the throw. I mean, that's normal. Going. Oh, he didn't go for the wall staying too. I would have wall staying too. That running three can't do anything about it. Oh, baited the rage art because he was in AOP. They think they always get that on us. Baited. So.
How do you think Rafume is doing today?
Rafume?
Is he on point? Is he as good as usual, or what do you think?
Punishment's all right, but definitely I've seen him play solid, more solid.
Okay, so
because see there, that's guaranteed.
Not
one hit, and if you get up or lie down, that's gonna hit you.
Okay, so not as good as usual, but you think still enough to beat fighter.
Oh yeah. I mean, you know, fighter is doing his best to defend, but the pace is too fast for him to actually think. And see, he's trying to, that would have caught probably me if I 4-4-3. He went for the running three, which crushed it.
All right. So, Rafume takes the first round.
Man, I got deathmatch this guy later. Actually, it's really tiring. I'm not going to lie. He's really tiring to fight against.
Okay, JT, out of you and Ruffinet, who do you think will win in a death match?
Wait, do I have to use Ling?
Yep.
Oh, he'd win.
So Ruffinet is better than you at Ling
in the mirror match.
All right. So Ruffinet, who's one of the other top Ling players?
You also have Neji Maki, aka Hide. He is actually, I'm going to say, the most knowledgeable Ling in Japan. He finds all of that Netta. Like, he is the first person on YouTube to post those Netta videos. They're all by him.
All right.
So he is always on the, he's always researching.
Okay.
Most, he's probably number two, and I'd be three.
All right. So Ruffinet, you put as the best Shaoyu player in Japan right now.
Based on rank. But
right.
Between the three of us, you know, depending on the day, could be anybody. Just depends how sharp y'all are.
Is Maxi still playing this game?
Maxi is still playing, but she's I think she's around Genbu as well.
Right.
And Tanukana. What the? Makita? Nande? Anyways, okay, the other Ling lost. But Tanukana is last time I looked, she's also top orange Roggle, and
right.
That's where Maxi is as well.
Right.
Okay, so, but I mean, there's actually a lot of Lings in the running for reds and for mid reds. Okay, going for the Oki. There you go.
Boom. Okay, so like Ruffinet.
I guess they're doing that one.
Ruffinet taking on 2-0.
Okay.
Not making a repeat of the last match.
See, look at that. On point.
On point punish over there.
Not on point.
Fighter trying to come in.
Good. Actually, you know, I'm going to be tied for three. Yoshiden is just as good.
Fighter coming in. Oh! Still gets some of that damage
forward,
in.
Forward one counter hit. You guys out? Oh, they're eating.
Boom! Oh, Fighter gets one round in. He's saying, I'm not getting out without a fight. This ain't over yet. Oh. Ruffinet trying to close this out.
See, that was a good reaction, but too slow. Or you know what? Probably a down forward one would have been better. Oh, he should have. I'd roll out. Okay. Good. See, you gotta look at that. He doesn't know to duck the second hit, meaning you could do it and keep going.
Oh, here comes a straight combo. Oh, he gets out of it.
Oh, called it. Oh, wow. Couldn't float that. All good.
Ah, nice. Okay. Ruffinet wins that match.
Called it.
Against Spider.
He looks sleepy. Ruffinet! Avoid the 9-0. I don't know where Deku is. I haven't really seen Deku in 7. What about you?
Deku.
Yeah. Okay. We're just figuring out the next match for our machines. Thanks everyone for sticking around. On one of the other streams, we have Mace versus Kagemaru, Jack versus Jack, one of the two best Jack players in Japan right now, playing head-to-head. Oh my god, this is a crazy match to see right now. I wish you guys can see it. If you guys go onto Shooty's stream, Kuro Kuro Cup 2 Twitch, you'll be able to see it. It's Jack versus Jack.
Not gonna lie, I'll take Kagemaru on that one.
What?
Yeah. Hey guys, so get this. We got 8 machines for the tournament. We got 8 for casuals. So there's 8 machines in the back, that's all free play. I wouldn't say he's one of the best. I mean, Mace had a solid rank, but
Mace is considered he's a very solid player. I don't think he's very underrated in Japan. I think Mace is a very, very solid Jack player, although not very, very well known. But Kagemaru is making very, very quick work of Mace. He wins one round. So, Kagemaru 1, Mace 0.
Oh.
Get ready for the next battle.
Round 1. Fight. Okay, so we have.
Oh god, the VF player. We got a VF player.
Shugagaga Kyoko versus Shaka.
No ground, no floor break, okay. Shaka with the offensive, going for the throw, gets the combo. That's over.
Shaka making easy work of Suga.
Oh, good conversion. Oh, nice try on the carry.
Tries to punish with a throw. Interesting.
Fiery. Okay.
Okay, Kazumi with a counter hit 4. Coming in for a break. Oh, no wall break there. Oh, trying to pressure him into it. Shaka takes on the second round.
Ankle breaking.
We've got this going on. Kazumi coming in. Tries to whip punish here. Counter hit 4, magic 4. Is he gonna break the wall? Yes, he breaks the wall. What's he gonna do from here?
Not a wall.
Okay, so Shugagaga.
Oh, good punish.
Still has a little bit of
step. Oh! Blocked it!
Shaka has the game.
What's he gonna do? Went for the tiger, unblockable tackle!
Shugagaga not really looking to wall break this.
That's it.
Boom, boom.
Oh, what? Tries cocky to go, here. He got cocky.
Tries going for the wall. Tries going for the wall combo, but misses it.
23-2. Got cocky. Oh, Kagemaru Masa 1-1.
All right, so
first game
we have Pantless Law versus Idol Kazumi.
Seriously, you have to change your hair to put on any costume.
Yep.
Oh, sorry. We got Summer. We got Summer Law. Summer Dapper Law.
We have Undy Law Idol Kazumi.
Okay, 444, nothing. He's going for the counter hits.
Undy's trying to get the plus frames.
Yeah, he
beating up Idol.
It's begun. The law makes it that begun.
Oh,
why?
Bam!
Why?
Undy's all like, you got that all about that base.
Okay, about that base. Running two, no, goes for that. It's safe. So
Idol
okay.
Trying to get that the running two to hit.
Oh, it
gets
hit.
One a hit.
Down two.
Boom.
Became a close game out of nowhere. Oh, blocked it.
Idol Kazumi gets that one hidden.
She's playing very, she's being a very good
flapping
idol
her
for
wings
everybody.
Like she has no, she's like an angel.
She must have had some Red Bull earlier. I think that's how she does the running too so fast.
Andy Law.
Okay, went for the command throw. He's respecting his base, trying to get her to come in.
Andy Law trying to bring it back.
He's trying to get the counter hit.
Trying to fish for the counter hit with her undies. Yo, fishing for those panty counter hits.
Ada throw instead.
Idol Kazumi.
Oh, she tried to gamble.
Idol
Shaka
Kazumi.
Gambling. Trying to pay off. Oh. You dead though. Oh, you ain't dead.
Oh, Kazumi bringing out her first single.
Oh, look at that. She would have had it if he kept going for it. Shaka kept going for it.
We got Mad Dog Jin.
Huh?
Mad Dog Jin.
Is that really him though? Okay then. All right, going downstairs. We going downstairs. Boom. And again. And okay, trying to go for the Oki. Nice. That was a scary mix-up. Okay. Okay. Try it again.
Idol coming in for the kill.
Scott could not get out.
Oh. She's breaking records.
She's playing a very idyllic play style. Okay, going downstairs. Oh.
Pretty good reach.
Oh,
Idol Kazumi in trouble now. Oh, panty.
444 gets counter hit.
Wow.
We downstairs again. We in the basement.
Boom.
Oh, lived through it, but didn't
live through that. What a panty dropper right there.
Kagemaru down. Kagemaru down. Mace beat Kagemaru. Okay, 444. Good combo. All right.
Wow, that hurt.
Boom. Oh, and that's the wall.
Guess that wall combo.
Yeah, that game.
Boom, boom,
she got
boom.
Fancy on him.
Boom. Kazumi drops those panties.
She was all like, Tiger. There ain't no Tiger uppercut, though.
No Tiger uppercuts this time around, but we got a lot of Idol.
I think she's going to make a song about this match.
It'll be a hit single.
That lasts like 10 years.
Okay, we have Amigo and Okati up next.
All right, Nidai Minnesota, I'm coming up.
Get ready for the next battle.
Right. Nidai Minnesota, let's see how this is. You're gonna see a stark contrast from Rafume, who went for the pure solid style. This one's gonna be just frame fucking the shit out of him.
Wow, okay, so Gathera Kanata versus Omar.
Here we go. There it is, all the frames. All the
Omar
frames.
Musuman.
There you go.
Making quick work out of Gathera Kanata right now.
Yep.
Gets into the wall.
Look at that! No!
Crushes
no.
the wall down for full crash down for two.
Look at that! Gimmicks!
Crushes a mid.
No F's given.
Oh man.
No F's given.
Hold on, Musume crushes a mid to get on the first round. That's how you start a match.
And that's how you don't start a match. All right. Let's see if he can pick it up again. Nope, fell for another one.
Another kind of coming in for a second launch.
See, this is the weakness of Lings that don't know how to stop.
The boom. Good
side, nice. Good fake. Hey!
Boom.
Look at that. Man, this guy could do better than this. This guy gets way more crazy.
So how does Omar Musume play? It can contrast
to
Rafume.
Oh, there's no basics going on right here. This is all flowchart. Pure flowchart. Nothing is reactionary.
Right. So
no punish.
So
no punish.
Minimal punishing. More about the gimmicks and flow of the game.
Yeah. No, he plays almost exactly like Sodam would.
Okay. I see.
Except Sodam has way better punishment.
All right.
Look at that. Boom. Told you. You know, ever since Ling came out, I think she's been the bane of King's existence. Because I've been playing with one of the former best kings of America for years.
Right.
K30.
Right.
Hates me. All day.
All right.
Do you know the tracking mid of 4-4?
Yep.
Don't mean crap.
Okay.
That's how he locked you down for like 3 Tekkens. Ling's like, I don't care. AOP's out of it, launches him. Guy shook his head and said, so scrubby.
Yep, that's like, how it should be.
For like 6 years. Said to me for 6 years.
Wow.
Hey, the guy don't play anymore. K30's still good if he picked up the game. Look at that. That was actually reactionary. He read that hit.
Omar Musume trying to get a second round on.
Second game. Oh! Boom. The mind fuck!
Oh!
And he eats. He should have done the whole thing and take as many hits as he could.
Bam! Look at that damage.
Eh. And didn't mean anything.
Omar Musume gets on the first round.
This is why Kings play really slowly against the Shaoyus. Because really the only thing they could really rely on is down forward one.
Right, okay.
Everything else can get crushed.
Boom! Oh, nice!
Zero fuck! It don't stop! Don't stop! When do the buttons stop getting hit? Oh, they don't. I'm sorry. Look at that. Don't stop!
Wow. Gathera Kanata really doesn't know what to do here.
Die.
But die.
Sorry, you put a Ling on there. I'm going to tell you what's going to happen if it's the right Ling. Look at that. He's so shocked he couldn't duck. Oh, crossover! He fucked up. He's gonna win anyway. It might even be perfect. Nope, it's not. I've lied. I'm sorry.
Oh, giant swing.
Don't matter. He didn't break it. It don't matter.
Oh, my worst man.
Oh, hey. Noise here. Told you. It don't matter. When a link goes crazy.
It just goes crazy.
Just go crazy. It don't stop. This Ling is one of the scariest Lings in Japan. He may not be one of the top, but that's purely on basics.
So Omar Musumeh takes on the first round.
Yeah. Well, he gets through the first round of losers.
So how's it going?
Just chilling, having fun. Oh, he has to fight fighter again. Oh my god, poor fighter. Oh my god. So when Robin was playing earlier, he played fighter, and poor fighter, his next opponent is now Oman. Poor guy's gonna get raped by the two of the best Lings in Japan. This guy's like gonna quit the game. Oh, hey.
Where's mine?
You want to do some commentating?
What's that?
No, you want some commentating?
No.
Let's go. Need the Filipinos to do it.
Yeah, Filipinos.
Let's go.
All right, gotta turn the stream into a Filipino match.
Okay, so it's gonna be a Tagalog stream now.
Hi, magandang hapon po. Nandito po tayo ngayon sa Kurukuru Cup.
Hey guys, what's up? This is Kraus.
Where are you going?
Hey, where are you going, dude?
Huh?
Taking a break.
We're gonna walk around while you guys are here. You guys are over there.
Do you know where can we play free? I mean, those machines are not used.
Huh?
Those machines are not used, right?
Oh, those are free, yeah. It's only these eight that are for tournament.
Sige po, mga bossing, laro-laro muna.
Welcome to the King of Lin Xiaoyu.
Well, that was the shortest commentary in history.
Get ready for the next battle.
Oh, Rafame's on Kuril's mainstream.
Round one. Fight.
Oh, yep, Allman versus Fighter right now. Let me change his name for you. Alrighty, there you go. Oh wow, okay, so Fighter putting up a much better fight this time. Except for right there.
Round two. Fight.
Allman showing us what he's made of. That's not what he's made of. Allman desperate to get to Ling his way out of this. Oh, and there he goes. Is he gonna rage art it? Nope, he's trying to Oki. Oh, so cocky! So cocky! Run up nothings everywhere! See? He's going for flowchart. It's the greatest strength of him, but it's also his weakness. Flowcharting. See? No punishment. But definitely fun to watch. All right, got it, got it. Why? Okay. Oh my god, to the back of the head! All right, good conversion to combo. All right, trying to psych him out into the low. He eats a giant swing. That's the round. That's the round. What we got next? Okay, went for a slide. Man, fighter is not really sure what to do. Okay. That is actually a legitimate combo. Straight into the into Shining Wizard. It does a lot. Think of how scaling works? All right, he doesn't know to block the low. Just got... Oh, man. Psyching him out. Trying to get out. What's he gonna do? He didn't put anything in. Oh, Oman lost. Got desperate. Game over. Later, Time Punk. Thanks for watching with us. Wonky, you should update to Windows 10. Alrighty, so game one to Fighter, surprisingly. Sorry guys, I have bias, not gonna lie. Well, it's not just bad, well, you know. Like I said, Oman's a flow charter, so that's the weakness. It's a strength and the weakness. He's not abusing the fact that Fighter doesn't know what to do. Okay. All right, good. See, now he's gonna, I think he's gonna play more, a little more guaranteed now and stop taking the gambles. Nice, very nice. Timed it perfectly to get the wall standing four as a counter hit. Okay, 4-2-1, don't know why. Trying to climb straight on. Probably empty jump in AOP. Okay, missed the RDS 4. There you go, just what I was talking about. 4-4 don't work. You should have done that when you first installed it, Wonky. All right, 1-1. Oh, with a crossover! Oh, eating two! Hey, two black bombs! Round four. Fight. Alright, Chinese lift kick. Try going for the crossover on the tech. Okay, getting screwed. Okay, didn't while standing forward. Try to get a counter hit. Try to get the duck. Oh my god, down forward one everywhere! Is Oman gonna get knocked out by this? Just king down forward ones? Alright, good punish. Alright, good. Alright, good read. Take what you can, Oman. Okay. Oh, very convincing. Game two goes to Oman.
Welcome to the King of Lin Shao.
All right, final match, Oman versus Fighter.
ready for the next battle.
All right, we got Wallace stage here. Let's see how, what Oman does. Is he good? Oh, he missed. Okay, all right, going for that Oki. Ah, oh, he canceled it, ate the knuckle bomb. Okay, trying to flip kick out. Nope, try to roll out. Oh, okay. Okay, good follow up. Good punish. Running three. Once again, he didn't duck it. Eating up count board ones everywhere. That's over. Oh! Oman! Oh my god, what the heck? Stepped on a foot. I stepped on his foot. I would not give that round to him. I'm not gonna lie. Oh! Baited!
All right, we're back.
1-1.
Oman Musume versus Fighter. 1-1. Fighter. How is this happening? Oman Musume on.
I think he's getting a little too excited and went too crazy at the first.
Boom. Oman Musume takes it over 2-0.
The gimmicks.
Gimmicks are going wild right here over in Akihabara, Tokyo, Ledgerland. That's what we're talking about here. Plus frames for Fighter. Let's see how he can push it out. Gets in the first blood. 2 down 4, 1-2.
There we go.
Oman Musume gets the first launcher on a wall of stage. Oh, tries to go in for 4-4-3, but doesn't reach.
I think it was running 3.
Oman Musume really trying to get this round to really finish. He wants it to end so badly, but Fighter's not coming out without a fight.
He's slowing down. He's actually conscious.
Oh, Fighter tries to go for a punish, but doesn't understand that move can get them down on grounded. Oman Musume trying to go for the plus frame. Mix up. Boom.
Why'd you duck?
Gets in for that launcher. Oman Musume 3-0. Wins the round. And kicks out Fighter.
There's only one move that can get you it, that. There's only one good low and 5 good mids. Why would you duck?
Well, it all comes down to the nerves of the fighter, and it really just comes down.
No, I think he saw a yen on the ground.
Yeah, that could be a treasure as well. Ooh, 1 yen.
Ooh, 1 yen.
Ah! Fuck, I just got launched.
Worth it. Wonky Osotsuki. If you go to the Kurokuro mainstream, it'll be Oman versus Amigo. That's going to be fun because you got one of the most solid players in the country versus one of the most gimmicky in the country. Who's going to make sense of what?
And on the other Twitch stream, we have Kagemaru versus Hagu. One of the best Lily players versus one of the best Jack players in the country.
Yep. Nice. Okay, looks like we're finishing up the fifth pool. My pool is going to be starting next. So all the matches are going to be on Shudi and Kurokuro's streams now until pool 6 starts. So you guys feel free to hang out here or you can check out the other streams too. Yeah, on Cup 2 right now we have Kagemaru versus one of the best lilies in the country. So it's a really good match to watch. Or if you go to Kurokuro stream, it'll be Oman, the Xiaoyu player, aka Nidai Sodam, versus Amigo, one of the best, probably the highest ranked Jin in the country.